Hey guys, welcome back to another Redbeard Outdoors episode. Today I'm in South Texas. I'm on a private ranch, little creek, river, pond, whatever you want to call it. It's kind of the whole mixture, and it's like crystal clear. It's really shallow, so I'm gonna have to be real sneaky, sneak up on them. I was told there's catfish and largemouth in here, so hopefully I can get them to come out of this grass right here. They're probably down underneath it, and get some reaction bites. So I'm gonna sneak around over to this ledge over here and see if I can catch them out of a deep spot over there. So that's where I'm gonna start. Okay, just a disclaimer, I've never fished this pond before, so I have no idea how it's gonna fish, but hopefully, maybe I can find a giant in here. Nice little dam right here. He's like face down in the grass. Got him. Oh, he's big. Oh, he's big. Oh! Oh, it came off. Shoot. God dang it. I don't think so. Probably a 3-pounder, 4-pounder. You should have seen him. He just had his face down in the grass and he was sleeping. I put it right on him and woke him up. Yeah, looked like he was sleeping. Let's see if I can find another one like that. He was pretty camo.
Got one. Bass. It ain't bad either. No. He's a little smaller than that. There we go. Dang, he choked it. There we go. Popped right out. I think he had the worm swallowed, but not the hook. I think I just caught him by the worm.
Do you eat them in general or not really?
Bass? No. They're more of a sport fish. Some people eat them, I don't. All right, guys, that was about a 2-pounder. It's been pretty tough. It took me a while to catch that. They know I'm up here, so kind of makes it difficult to catch him. Finally. About the same size as that last one. There we go. Okay. I'm gonna try to drop him away from where I was fishing. Super stealthy here, guys. These fish are super skittish. Really smart.
It was really tough. You gotta be so sneaky. They're pretty smart and skittish, and they weren't biting very well. Right off the bat, there was probably a 3 or 4 pounder with his nose in the grass, and it looked like he was sleeping. So I dropped a worm right next to him, and it woke him up, and he ate it. And you know, as you guys saw in the footage, I fought him for a little bit, and he just popped. I don't think the hook truly got set. He just had a hold of the bait, I guess is what happened. I'm not sure. So anyways, not very much fish in here, actually. It's a flowing creek, so it probably loses a lot of fish, and they're hard to keep. But if I had to guess in total, there's probably like 75 fish in here. Based off of what I saw and what I fished for. So a bunch of small ones, a couple medium ones, and then just that one big one. And then I saw a few catfish too. This video isn't over. I'm probably going to come back to here sometime. Or if not here, I'm going to go fish another creek. So I'll see you guys there. All right, guys. Well, that was tough fishing right there. I couldn't get a single bite out of that place. So you're not gonna see much footage here, but it was pretty, so I'll just add this to the video.
this guy. Blowing up my fishing hole, man. Done fishing yet. Hopefully I can find another spot and or go back to that other ranch place, but stay tuned.
Hey guys, we're back at the Clearwater Lake and I'm going to try to sneak over there today, be a little bit more quiet, and see if I can sneak up on these fish, and maybe they're biting a little bit more today. There's definitely more water flowing through it, so let's see if I can get a little bit better of a bite today. With the whopper. Barely hooked. There we go, first fish. They definitely like stuff landing on top of the water, so first cast with the whopper plopper. I think this is actually the first fish I've ever caught with a whopper plopper. So, pretty awesome. Second cast. Wow, barely hooked. Second cast. Whoppa floppa. Biggest one yet. Oh, that's a nice one, boys and girls. Ouch, ouch, ouch. That's not a bad one. not that heavy. It's super skinny. Probably about 2.5 pounds. Not bad though. See him. Barely even swimming off. Alright, so the way I played that one is I threw it over there and I saw water movement, so I just kind of stopped, and then he reached out and grabbed it. So slow and steady wins the race. I slipped and fell on my butt on the dam. I'm soaked. I didn't fall in, I landed on top of the dam. But yeah, that sucked. Anyways, I wasn't filming, trying to save battery life. I'm gonna relocate and try to get over here to another side. Different spot with a different hole, so. Bad one. I've been seeing some big ones swimming over here. Baby. Oh, just a little tiny guy. What are you trying to eat that for? Baby. I don't know how much I've been getting on film, but my SIM card got full and I've been catching them like crazy, and hopefully I got most of that on film, but I don't know, I've caught about 8 or so fish over here, so I'm gonna hurry up and get back in. I'm losing daylight, so I don't have much time left.
pole with me. Thank God. Whew. That's gonna do it for here, guys. Great night tonight. Bad day filming. I'm not sure how much I got on there, but hopefully I got some. Especially, I caught like a 3.5 pounder. Had a huge mouth on it, super skinny, but hopefully all that shows up in the video. I'm keeping my fingers crossed, because when my SIM card ran out of space, instead of sending off a warning like it should, it just froze, and I had to pull the battery, and who knows if I got any of that footage, but we'll find out. So
paper thin.
Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed this episode. Smash that like button for clear water fishing and for whopper plopper fishing. Make sure to subscribe and stay tuned. I'll see you guys on the next Redbeard Outdoors episode. Remember, get outdoors and keep fishing. I'll catch you guys later. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
Thank you.